come back to you with notes on it?
No.
Or is it just, that's what's going on the field,
yeah.
100%?
Yeah.
That's a matter of trust for a performer.
That is amazing.
Yeah.
Right.
And he says, surprise me. You know, I mean, he just wants the most creativity from you.
And you,
that's cool.
Yeah, you can't deny, like, that's a nice thing, because there's a lot of other directors or just more film production companies that want to make sure their P's and Q's are all the way they want.
That's not a control thing, it's just, you know, they don't want to be blindsided, you know? But it's, a, I would say it's more of a trust thing with itself.
Well, and speaking of that, Melissa, on the production side of things, you have moved into executive producing a couple of or a decade plus ago now?
Yeah, I think it's been within the last 10 years I decided, you know, I love acting and love it, but producing was very exciting too because you're putting the whole project together from the beginning to the end. And, you know, when I met Dave, I was like, all the wheels were turning. I had this sort of cool sandbox of actors that I met at conventions and other films, and so I wanted to put these films together and work with them.
And host a certain day.
Yeah, I guess I could host the panel. Thanks.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Idea.
I think you'd be perfect. We've got the artist one coming up later. We'd love to have you on.
I'm going to hit the airport.
Ah!
Yeah, so, and I've learned so much from him just as an actor. I just want to say that, like, I felt like all the characters I've created since meeting him had taken, I would say they've all, you know,
gone downhill.
I understand better how to create, like, in a bigger way than talking about.
Yeah.
Right?
I love that. Thank you. Yeah.
I love, somebody clapped for that. I love that. Thank you.
Yeah, I'll just tell you
that's
this. I would say that I always tell her to just let it go more on how funny she is, because she is so funny. And a lot of times people don't know their boundaries in the funny. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, so I think she's explored playing funnier characters.
And Victor Crowley, that was the first film I did with her, and
she steals the movie.
So I'm like, do more of that.
Much more of that.
I do love comedy. I love horror comedy. So I love all the action movies.
So, we were talking about connection that you would like to work with and things like that. Is there somebody you have not, both of you, have not worked with in the horror community that you're like, that's a, I wanna be on that project with that person at some point?
Hello, Quentin Tarantino. How are you doing, Quentin?
Yeah, I'd love to work with you, and I'd love to work with Eli Roth. And I met Eli, he's such a phenomenal filmmaker. And fortunately, he and I had that conversation because I'm so grateful that he really loves Sleepaway Camp.
Oh, yeah.
So we actually saw him sent me this freaked out with a little clip of Quentin and Eli chatting about it.
I've seen that.
That's crazy. That's how we knew today. I was hoping one person would see Sleepaway Camp. So, you know,
Let's all take a breather on that. weird. That was a picture. He was about to throw him out. Nobody said that to him. No. At some conventions recently, starting as early as March, was that it? In Vegas?
Yes, March.
Vegas. Has been doing photo ops in costume of the final scene from Sleepaway Camp.
Woo! Yes, so.
Half you're applauding, the other half is going, wait, I know what the final scene is. Unless you pay more.
There is a spare. This is standard penis.
Stunt.
I always want to make sure his photographs well.
Oh, good. Did you think I had your own penis?
I did think my own penis.
Tell us stuff, Robert.
We now get to do that.
Who would love to know how that is?
Are there photo ops?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
called no music shows.
Don't talk yet.
I gotta do my left arm because I broke my right arm right before. If you have not, by the way, then you talk to Task Commander here too, because Starship Troopers at the beginning of filming of that, he broke 3 ribs and also did not tell anybody, so he didn't get replaced.
And the only reason they would never replace me as Doofy, but they would have said, well, because I was calling off the stunt guys for all the stunts. I was like, no, I want to do it. No. And then they shook me down. They took me to lunch, the stunt team, and said, you know Paul? And I go, no, I haven't met Paul. And he goes, Paul's your stunt dummy. You're a stunt dummy. Stunt dummy. Yeah. That's why you haven't met him, because you're doing your own stunt. I mean, yeah, you know, like, it's, I want to bring comedy. Well, Paul's got 2 kids. He doesn't get paid unless he does stunts. And then we're at the Taco Bell thing, and they go, you can keep doing your own stunts, but we're also responsible for you, you know, not getting hurt during your stunts. And we hate to see you get hurt. That's why we'd rather have Paul in there. So if they were if you want to jump through that window in that last scene, we're not responsible for your safety, but we're responsible for Paul's safety. And that's how that
Paul
do it. Yeah, Paul can do that. I didn't do running down the staircase from the piano and going up and kicked out the window. That was Paul. You know that's not
Paul.
Yeah. But that's why I didn't tell them about that. On House 2, it's the blue character, when I smashed my nuts on the tree. I didn't get hurt on that because it was a damn number. But then I fall to the ground and it had a hat buried in bark.
Yeah.
But they had that gardening liner thing.
Oh, shit.
Which is like hard PVC.
Yeah.
And it was out of the ground about 2 inches as like the between the grass and the bark. And I overshot the thing and I hit a rib, so I did break it up. I broke like 1 rib.
Ah!
And that's, if you see the bark, I go, shut up, get hurt. I actually was like horribly hurt. But I wouldn't tell them that.
Yeah.
I didn't want to say. She injures herself all the time.
All the time. Like, come on.
Yeah.
How old are you going to be?
You had to tell them.
Because I think that's more fun.
Of course.
budget a producer for their community interview off their Rebecca's album. And I'm friends with Delardo, who is running, who's managing, and he said, he called and said, hey, do you know anyone? I said, well, come on, let me check with you. So I went to the office and met with the team, and I was like, we're going to make more of these. And they were like, what? And I said, let's make Slayer more rooms and I'll bring friends in. You know, they were like, can you do that? So we brought in a bunch of directors, we hired DJ McDonald from Manchester Beach, and we went with David Chan, we Tyler Vane, Derek Beers, from the Well, Sean Brown. So, I didn't know David at the time. This was 2015. And we made three videos back to back, and it was so fun, and I love Slayer. We can check it out.
But David, I'm going to go lose you to myself, David.
Oh, yeah. You should. I didn't know. It was 2015. It's so weird. We had it over. We met them one time.
They're making their return.
Yes!
In October, Aftershock here.
There's so much.
Right there. Question for Dave. So I heard that they're going to be rebooting the Scary Movie pretty soon. And I just wanted to get your thoughts on that and see if you're open to returning.
I'm definitely open to returning. I have talked with them, and I don't know anything about the premise. I can't tell you that. I do know that Ghostface will be involved. So, and I own the masks. So that's how I really pitched them. Like, you know, I own the masks. You can save money. Because it'll be that same thing as, like, you know, Scream 6, where it's like the original old mask. I'm like, oh, I have the original old mask. Wait a second. You know, like, that saves thousands of dollars, you know. So we'll see what happens.
Yeah, the legacy horror nowadays taking over.
Exactly.
It'd be so awesome to see that.
Yeah. Yeah. If anything, I might just be the voice of Ghostface, since I was the voice of that one. That'd be the least amount. I would say it's probably hard to get the 2 feet back, where we're now in a different age. But I think I pitched them producers, like, they're running, they just open a door, and I'm inside with the back.
Just
it. Just make it.
Yeah, yeah,
you don't disturb me. You shut it. Never would have.
That'd be perfect.
Yeah, I love that. You get to keep both halves, she gets to keep both penises.
Next question, I mean, we have one right over here.
Thank you so much. Angela
Baker,
Angela
Baker,
yeah. So
Oh my God.
both of you. What was, and you kind of answered this earlier, maybe a little bit, but what was it like to both die in your travel?
You can answer yours.
Well, for me, it was a journey. Because I was always obsessed with passion, and I was obsessed with everything, and I was obsessed with being on. So it was like a trifecta of, I'm doing what? And when I read the script for the first time, Adam has the entire cast come to the studio. We all sit with cameras in front of us, and you read the script together, and then your character dies, and you blow out your candle. And I had to read out loud how I was dying.
Thank you.